Cities. Let's go straight to the reason why you probably clicked on this video. According to the UN population estimate, the 10 biggest cities in the world are Osaka in Japan, Dhaka in Bangladesh, Beijing in China, Mumbai in India, Cairo in Egypt, Mexico City in Mexico, São Paulo in Brazil, Shanghai in China, Delhi in India, and Tokyo in Japan. A city is a large human settlement, and that description from Wikipedia kind of sounds like the way an alien would describe it. But anyway, there are around 10,000 cities in the world, which for some reason seems like not that much, but they house 55% of the world's population. But countries vary in the way they define cities. For instance, some say any settlement with over 1,500 people is a city, others demand higher population numbers for it to be considered as such. Either way, the point of this video isn't to list out all cities in the world. That would probably take a little longer than a few minutes. The point of this video is to find out which the largest cities in the world are, the ones I just listed at the beginning. I use the UN population estimate because it seems to be the most accurate, but there are other ways to measure this, sometimes with different results. Do we consider population or territory size? And in either of those cases, what do we define as being the limits of a city? The municipality area, the metropolitan, the urban area? There are just too many variables and ways of looking at it. Not to mention the fact that if we go by active population, 6 out of the top 10 are in China. That would make for a pretty boring video of just touring Chinese cities. So after having listed those top 10 biggest ones according to the UN, here's what I'm gonna do in this video. I'm going to quickly summarize and talk about the top 10 largest cities in the world and their history, and then, as to not leave out most of the world, I'll very quickly and briefly go continent by continent and pick out a few other interesting ones that by little population difference don't make it into this top 10. Tokyo is the biggest city in the world, the seat of the Japanese government and of the Emperor of Japan. Originally a fishing village named Edo, the city became a prominent political center in 1603 when it became the seat of the Tokugawa shogunate. A fun fact, it began as a fishing village, and today the city's fish market is the largest in the world. Once a tuna fish was sold for $1.7 million. By the mid-18th century, Edo was one of the most populous cities in the world at over 1 million people. Following the end of the shogunate in 1868, the imperial capital in Kyoto was moved to the city, which was renamed Tokyo, literally meaning Eastern Capital. Today, its urban area holds more than a quarter of Japan's total population. Like Tokyo for Japan, Delhi is the capital of India. Delhi is one of the oldest cities in the world and has been continuously inhabited since the 6th century BC. It's been a capital of various empires throughout history, like the Tomars, the Chahamanas, the Delhi Sultanate, or the Mughal Empire. In 1803, during the Second Anglo-Maratha War, the forces of the British East India Company defeated the Maratha in the Battle of Delhi, and it became a part of British India, even being chosen as British India's capital when they moved it from Kolkata in 1911. Eventually, as we know, India became independent, and this is now its capital city. Before we keep going with the video, a quick message about today's sponsor, Endel. Endel is an app that offers personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. They offer solutions for three problems that people usually have. If you're having a hard time focusing on daily tasks, Endel helps you focus while you study or work, boosting your productivity. If you're suffering from stress or anxiety, Endel calms your mind, allowing you to relax. And if you're not getting enough sleep or quality sleep, Endel soothes you into a deep sleep, allowing you to rest better. Their sounds are personalized to your specific needs. For instance, it reacts to inputs like the time of day, the weather, or your heart rate. And they don't just use random sounds, they have science to back it up, with an actual research on sound and sleep using a patented technology. There's a science tab on their website that you can visit to learn about all of the science behind it. The first 100 people to download Endel through the link in the description will get a free week of audio experiences. Thank you to them for sponsoring this video. Shanghai in China. China is the third biggest city in the world and home of the world's longest subway system, over 600 kilometers long. It's one of only 4 Chinese cities governed directly by the government. It's the most populous city proper in the world, ahead of Delhi and Tokyo, but this ranking also partly takes into account the surrounding metropolitan areas. Like Tokyo, it was originally a fishing village, gaining importance in the 19th century due to both domestic and foreign trade and its favorable port location. In this painting, we can see the old walled city city of Shanghai in the 17th century. The city was forced to open to European trade after the First Opium War against the British, and it was here that in 1863 the Shanghai International Settlement was created. In its seal, we can see the flags of all European colonial powers who held domains in this area, perhaps paving the way for the important international business center that it is today. São Paulo in Brazil is the fourth largest worldwide, and apparently has the third worst commute time average, with people taking an average of 93 minutes to get to work. Its state, also called São Paulo, is the most populous and wealthiest of Brazil. However, when the Portuguese established a settlement there, it was one of the poorest regions of their Southern American colony. The Portuguese weren't the first to live there though, and natives known as the Tupi people had already been around for a long time. The colonial village was founded with the creation of a Jesuit college of 12 priests who wanted to convert the natives to Christianity. Eventually, in the 17th century, with the discovery of gold in nearby areas, more people started migrating to the village, allowing it to grow and become a full city by 1711. When the gold ran out, they began growing sugar and exporting it through the city's ports, increasing its wealth. When Brazil became independent in 1822, São Paulo was declared an imperial city, a sign of its growing importance until today. A fun fact, the city has the largest Japanese immigrant community in the world, with an estimated 1.5 million people of Japanese origin. Mexico City in Mexico occupies the number 5 slot in this top 10 of biggest cities. Mexico's capital is the oldest capital city in the Americas, one of only two founded by indigenous people. The other is Quito in Ecuador. It was originally built on an island of Lake Texcoco by the Aztecs in 1325, being called Tenochtitlan. This version of the city was almost completely destroyed in the 1521 siege and subsequently redesigned and rebuilt by the Spanish colonizers. Mexico City was the political, administrative, and financial center of a major part of the Spanish colonial empire. After independence from Spain was achieved, the federal district was created in 1824 as the capital of independent Mexico, and so we can see its importance throughout history, first as the capital of the Aztecs, then of the Spanish colonial empire, and then of independent Mexico. It's also unique in the fact that it's the only one of these gigantic cities that has more than 2,400 hectares of UN-protected ancient farmland inside of its borders. Cairo in Egypt is the sixth largest in the world, the only one in Africa to make it into this top 10, and we should note there is not a single European city in it. Cairo is the capital of Egypt and home to more than 25% of Egyptians. Known for its proximity to the Pyramid of Giza, the only of the seven wonders of the ancient world that still exists. The ancient city of Memphis, where ancient Egypt had its capital, I believe, was also located in this area. And so we could argue that it's been settled and served as the capital of the region for literally thousands of years. And even just Cairo itself was founded in 969 AD during the Fatimid dynasty. At the time, they also built one of the world's oldest universities there, the Al-Azhar Mosque, and Cairo became a center of learning, also becoming the official capital in 1168. The Cairo Citadel, built by Sultan Saladin in 1169, served as the seat of government of Egypt until the 19th century. Maintaining much of its importance through Ottoman and then British occupation, it became the capital again upon full independence. Since the 1960s, its population has doubled, and its growing tendency continues. Going back to India, we have Mumbai at number 7, previously known as Bombay, India's leading financial city. Every day, over 200 trains go into the city, with people traveling to work, the world's busiest railroad. Mumbai is built on what was once an archipelago of 7 islands, and has been inhabited for thousands of years. In the 3rd century BC, the islands formed part of the Maurya Empire, for instance, and changed hands of local rulers for some time. Eventually, it was a part of the Mughal Empire, who in 1534 were forced to cede the city to the Portuguese, who heavily developed the area for their own colonial benefit, building many religious places and fortifications. Through royal marriages and purchases, the islands of the city slowly made their way into the possession of the British. In 1668, they were leased by the British government to the East India Company for £10 a year. I imagine a symbolic value. And it was at this time that the city really began to grow. In 1661, it had 10,000 people, and by 1675, that number had increased to 60,000. Continuing to grow throughout British occupation. The opening of the Suez Canal in 1869 transformed Bombay into one of the largest seaports of the Arabian Sea. Upon India's independence in 1947, the city started growing even more, with massive expansion taking place. The local port still handles around 55% of all of India's sea cargo. Also traveling back to China, Beijing. China's capital and the world's most populated capital city, also directly ruled by the state council. Council. Beijing is one of the oldest cities in the world as well, dating back 3,000 years. It's the last of the four great ancient capitals of China and has been the political center of the country for most of the past 8 centuries. Humans have lived there for 27,000 years, and the first walled settlement dates back to 1045 AD, first being the capital of the state of Yan. Changing hands a lot throughout many rulers, it became the capital of the Ming Dynasty and all of China in 1420, the same year the Forbidden City was completed. Throughout the following centuries, it always occupied an important role in Chinese history and governance up to modern times. Interestingly, in an effort to prevent pollution in 2017, the Chinese government announced plans to limit the capital's population to 23 million people. I'm not sure if this has been done or not. Dhaka in Bangladesh is next. It ranks number 9 in terms of population, but is the 6th most densely populated worldwide. The area of Dhaka has been inhabited since the first millennium, rising to prominence in the 17th century as a provincial capital and commercial center of the Mughal Empire, the center of the Muslim trade in Bengal. It was one of the most prosperous cities in the world at the time, attracting many European traders because of its seaport, even being called the Venice of the East. In 1947, after the end of British rule, the city became the administrative capital of East Pakistan. In 1971, it became the capital of an independent Bangladesh and still holds great importance for the country, region, and even the world. Osaka in Japan is number 10. Osaka was considered Japan's economic hub in ancient times. By the Kofun period, it was an important port, but only on a regional level, briefly serving as the imperial capital in the 7th and 8th centuries. Osaka continued to flourish during the Edo period and became known as a center of Japanese culture. Following the Meiji Restoration, it expanded in size and quickly industrialized, contributing to the growth of its population and economy, attracting, for instance, many Korean immigrants. Osaka was the industrial center most clearly defined in the development of capitalism in Japan, and apparently known as the Manchester of the Orient. The city suffered a lot during World War II, but has since recovered and is now, for example, the 5th most expensive city to live in the world. And so, now that we got a better look at this top 10 and their historical context, let's go throughout the world, continent by continent, and simply list out some of the other biggest cities throughout the world. Starting with Europe, the two biggest cities in Europe are in countries that are also in Asia, but the cities themselves are in Europe. Istanbul is first with 15 million people, followed by Moscow with 12 million. Then London, St. Petersburg, Berlin, Madrid, Kyiv, Rome, Bucharest, I was surprised by this one, and Paris. Other big cities outside of Europe's top 10 are Vienna, Warsaw, Barcelona, Milan, among others. If you want, and let me know in the comments, if so, I can do specific videos for each of these, going more into depth at the history of the biggest or even the oldest cities per continent. In North America, the biggest is, as we saw, Mexico City, followed by New York, then Los Angeles, Toronto, Chicago, Houston, Havana, this one also surprised me, Montreal, Ecatepec de Morelos, and Philadelphia. Moving to Central and South America, São Paulo is the biggest, followed by Lima in Peru, Bogotá in Colombia, Rio de Janeiro, Santiago in Chile, Caracas in Venezuela, Buenos Aires in Argentina, Salvador in Brazil, and Brasilia. Then Africa, whose biggest city is Cairo, like we saw, followed by Lagos in Nigeria, whose population is actually larger than Cairo if we only consider the city limits themselves, but the UN uses different criteria apparently. Next is Algiers in Algeria, Casablanca in Morocco, Kinshasa, Brazzaville in Congo, and Johannesburg in South Africa. In Asia, the biggest ones are the ones we saw within that top 10, but some other very big ones are Karachi in Pakistan, Guangzhou in China, Jakarta in Indonesia, Lahore in Pakistan as well, Seoul in South Korea, Ho Chi Minh in Vietnam, and Bangkok in Thailand. And finally, in Oceania, where the top 10 has 8 Australian cities, one from New Zealand and one American, which is Honolulu in the US state of Hawaii. The biggest is Sydney, then Melbourne, Brisbane, Perth, Auckland, among other Australian ones. You might have noticed some of these actually surpass some we saw in the UN top 10 worldwide. This is because each country and each ranking has different ways of accounting for population. Some countries define a city as the city proper within geographic city limits. Others consider administration areas, others metropolitan or urban areas. So it's kind of confusing and impossible to compare them. The best option is, I think, using that first UN estimate. So those are the biggest cities in the world, the top 10 biggest in terms of population. How how they came to be settled and developed throughout history, providing a very quick summary of that historical path and a few interesting aspects about them at those times and today, as well as other cities throughout the world that are incredibly big, even if by a matter of small difference in population numbers, they don't make that top 10. Did I make any mistakes, or do you have any additional information? Let me know in the comments below. And also, if you'd like to see this for every continent, especially since Europe was very much left out, with historical facts about each continent's largest or oldest cities. Thanks so much for watching this video. Subscribe if you want, and I will see you next time for more general knowledge.